So you've had pain in your knee for a long time. You've tried a home exercise program, you've tried physical therapy, you've tried oral pain medications, you may have even tried cortisone injections. Take a look at these results. They are amazing. Pain improvement and functional improvement sustained for over 1 year. Data from multiple randomized controlled trials show that PRP injections work, and they work really well for the treatment of knee osteoarthritis. Let's talk about PRP injections. Hey everyone, my name is Dr. Jeff Pang. We're going to talk about platelet-rich plasma injections, also known as PRP injections, and we're going to talk about them in the use of treating knee arthritis. Once considered experimental, platelet-rich plasma injections were only available to the top of the top athletes as well as in clinical trials. Tiger Woods, Kobe Bryant, Rafael Nadal, Alex Rodriguez, what do all these all-time great athletes have in common when they got injured? They all used platelet-rich plasma injections to help them recover quicker from their injuries. Now PRP injections have become widespread in the treatment of professional athletes, college athletes, weekend warriors, the industrial athlete, and pretty much anyone else who wants to live an active and healthy lifestyle, but are limited by painful conditions. PRP injections fall under this big umbrella category called orthobiologics, also known as regenerative medicine. It's being used to treat a variety of orthopedic conditions such as injuries to muscles, tendons, ligaments, bones, and joints. But do they really work? What do clinical trials tell us about people who get PRP injections for the treatment of their orthopedic problems? Let's take a deep dive into one of the most studied and most supported indications for PRP injections, and that's in the use of treating knee arthritis. Now, people who suffer from knee arthritis can attest to the fact that this condition can be incredibly painful and can be debilitating, and our current treatment options right now in the treatment of knee arthritis is really just mediocre at best. So how does PRP injections compare to all our other treatment options? I've included a small sample of the rapidly growing body of evidence looking at using PRP injections to treat knee osteoarthritis. Let's go through some of these studies. This was a randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled trial comparing PRP injections to placebo, and the authors concluded intra-articular injections of platelet-rich plasma can provide clinically significant functional improvement for at least 1 year in patients with mild to moderate osteoarthritis of the knee. This prospective randomized controlled trial directly compared PRP injections to steroid injections, and they found that PRP injections demonstrated a statistically significant improvement over steroid injections in a 1 year follow-up time period. This study was a meta-analysis of 20 different randomized controlled trials comparing PRP injections to hyaluronic acid injections, and the authors concluded intra-articular platelet-rich plasma injections appeared to be more efficacious than hyaluronic acid injections for the treatment of knee osteoarthritis in terms of short-term functional recovery. Moreover, PRP injections was superior to hyaluronic acid injections in terms of long-term pain relief and functional improvement. The growing body of medical literature shows that platelet-rich plasma injections are better at improving short and long-term pain relief as well as functional improvement, and that's compared to placebo, compared to cortisone injections, compared to hyaluronic acid injections, and potentially compared to not doing anything at all. And the reason for that is that we are understanding that osteoarthritis is a chronic progressive disease. It tends to get worse over time. And that's why we see people go from mild to moderate to severe to bone-on-bone osteoarthritis. So we need to change the way we think about osteoarthritis. And platelet-rich plasma injections allow us to do that. Think about it this way. We don't wait for someone to have a heart attack or a stroke before we say, hey, we should probably treat your high blood pressure. If you have high blood pressure, whether you have any symptoms or not, we treat it. Because if we don't, it's going to lead to a heart attack, it's going to lead to a stroke. And we need to think about osteoarthritis in this same way. If you have osteoarthritis, if we don't treat it, it will get worse. And that's where platelet-rich plasma injections can potentially provide treatment. This study is titled Platelet-Rich Plasma Injections Delay the Need for Knee Arthroplasty. And what is knee arthroplasty? Knee arthroplasty means a knee replacement surgery. The authors conclude, these data suggest that the application of PRP in knee osteoarthritis patients is a treatment that could delay total knee arthroplasty. Here's my takeaway from all of these studies. PRP injections are safe, they're effective at treating knee osteoarthritis, symptom relief can be sustained for at least 1 year, and PRP injections can potentially delay the progression of osteoarthritis as indicated by delaying the need for a knee replacement surgery. That was a quick summary of the evidence behind the use of PRP injections for the treatment of knee arthritis, but now I want to help you understand the why and the how behind PRP. What are the platelets doing? Why does PRP work? How does platelet-rich plasma injections potentially delay the progression of knee osteoarthritis? And if you understand the concept behind all of this, you will start to see why so many orthopedists and sports medicine specialists are so excited about using PRP injections to help treat those who suffer from painful conditions. And the best way to understand this is to use the following analogy. Let's say that I fall and I have a big cut over my forearm. It's red, it's hot, it's swollen, it's angry, it hurts. Over time, a scab forms over this cut. Scab falls off, you get this pink-white looking granulation tissue, and if I give it a few months, I got brand new skin. This entire healing process is initiated and controlled by platelets. Our platelets are responsible for tissue healing, tissue remodeling, tissue proliferation, and most importantly, in controlling pain and inflammation. And so what we're doing with a platelet-rich plasma injection is we're taking your own platelets out, concentrating it, and then injecting it under ultrasound guidance back into an area that has been irritated or injured. And this is why we think PRP injections have so much potential in the treatment of orthopedic conditions. Now, historically, we gave cortisone injections. And cortisone is a steroid. It's a very strong pain medication, and it's a very strong anti-inflammatory medication. Think of it like getting a big dose of ibuprofen. But for anyone who's ever taken ibuprofen, you know the effects of ibuprofen are temporary, and the same is true of cortisone injections. Look at this graph. On the left shows people who got cortisone injections, and notice that they do get pain relief, but their pain levels get higher and higher with time. Now I'll look at the people who got PRP injections. These effects are sustained. PRP injections provide better pain relief and better functional outcomes, sustained for at least 1 year. And we think the reason for that is because PRP injections contain an incredible amount of growth factors, and this can help with tissue healing and providing pain relief. And just like how my laceration will continue to remodel over time, the effects of platelet-rich plasma injections can be sustained for a long period of time. Here lies the potential explanation for how PRP injections may delay the progression of knee osteoarthritis, as evidenced by the delayed need for a knee replacement. Recall that osteoarthritis is the gradual wear and tear and the loss of articular cartilage. And every time articular cartilage gets damaged or injured, they release a bunch of toxic enzymes and proteins into the joint. This toxic environment is what is causing all the symptoms that people who suffer from knee arthritis are so familiar with. The stiffness, the pain, the warmth, the inflammation, the restricted range of motion, the locking, the clicking. All of this is caused by that toxic environment. And the problem with this is the higher amount of toxic enzymes and proteins in that joint. What that does is it weakens your articular cartilage. All the healthy articular cartilage that is still intact is slowly weakened. And when they start dying off, they then release a bunch of toxic enzymes and proteins. This then further weakens the rest of the healthy remaining articular cartilage. And when they get injured, they then release a bunch of toxic enzymes and proteins. And this results in an avalanche effect. And this is why we see people go from mild to moderate to severe to bone-on-bone osteoarthritis in the span of a short time. And what platelet-rich plasma injections can do is introduce a huge amount of growth factors. And by introducing these growth factors, we try to reset the internal environment of the joint. We go from an environment that is really toxic and inflammatory all the way down to one that's more normal, one that's more neutral. And by doing so, we break this avalanche effect that is causing the progression of osteoarthritis, and we try to slow that down. A lot of my patients who have learned about platelet-rich plasma injections have decided to proceed with treatment. Many of these patients have decided to do it concurrently with either a home exercise program or physical therapy. Many people who have symptoms that are relatively well controlled still also continue to proceed with treatment, and that's to try to maintain the environment of their joint to hopefully delay the progression of their osteoarthritis. Thanks for watching. Please share this video with anyone who you know has arthritis, especially if they have osteoarthritis of the knee. PRP injections are new, and the more people who learn about it, the more people who can benefit from it. I'm also going to be making a video of all the frequently asked questions that I get on PRP injections. I will also be making more videos on PRP injections and all the other indications that it has been shown to be beneficial. You can find me on social media as well. I'm on Twitter at JeffreyPengMD. I also write on my blog at JeffreyPengMD.com. Thanks for watching.